Today is Thursday morning, 2 days after my appointment. I really haven't eaten in the last 2 days, so I'm just kind of curious because, like, I'm like, wow, so close. So I just woke up. It's like 4:04 a.m. Baby Jesus. Okay, so let's tear out. Gigi. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. Gigi? You gotta stop, little girl. No, don't come over here. Let's try this again. Fuck. All right. Third time's a charm. That's zero. You guys, right at the 30-day mark, we are at 299.8. Fuck yes. Good morning, love. So today is April 15th. It is 9:57 a.m. My appointment's at 10:15. It has been a shit show already this morning. I went to work at 7. I had to leave real quick so I could come to my appointment. And it's just like, it's already put me in a foul mood at work. Like, when I tell you this month has been stressful, it has been fucking stressful. Especially this last week because, for those of you that are in retail, maybe you'll know what I'm talking about. But I actually have my annual inventory this Thursday in like 2 days, and so it's just a matter of preparation and doing and counting and doing all these things, and like it's just like a lot of setbacks. So I have been extremely stressed. Not that it's an excuse, but I will say that I have been depending on energy drinks, not eating, but just energy drinks all motherfucking week. And the sad part is that I hit my goal like 2 days after I got my lash injection, but I didn't post anything. I only sent it to like my sister and a couple friends, and then I just felt defeated after that because I knew I was drinking and drinking and drinking monsters like nobody's business. So yeah, I did hit my goals. I'll insert a picture somewhere here maybe. I hit my goal like 2 days after I got my last injection, and I was so excited, but I didn't want to post it until I came and got my next shot because I just had a feeling that this week was going to be bad just because of the way work's been going, and I'm on vacation next week, so it'll give me opportunity to like jumpstart it. But I have my appointment in 15 minutes. I honestly have no high hopes. I'm just hoping that I didn't gain and that I either plateaued or lost maybe half a pound. Hopefully, I don't know. It's just, this week I think has been the most humbling out of all the weeks. Cause it put me in such a good spot. Like, I felt so good. And then after that, it was just like trash at work. I'm not sleeping. I'm sleeping maybe 3 or 4 hours a night, maybe 3 tops, 4 at the very, very, very most. So I know that's not working in my favor. I'm not going to the bathroom as normally as I used to. I used to be like punctual, like as soon as you wake up, as soon as I ate, as soon as I got home from work, as soon as I went to bed. Like, now it's barely anything, and I know it's because I'm not eating anything. So if the less you put in, the less it comes out, right? So I don't know. I'm just so anyways, let's go inside. Let's get this shit show over with. I will tell you this, like, my brain just farted. Like, I'm just like over it. I will tell you this, like, I do have incredible energy. I'm up all hours of the night doing all kinds of stuff. So I know that's a result of the shots. But my brain will not shut off. Like, I cannot get it to shut off. But other than that, I'm getting hunger pains this morning. Like, my stomach is growling right now as we speak. And it hasn't done that all week. So today, you can tell it's starting to wear off, because I'm starting to feel it this morning that my stomach is really grumbly tumbly. So I don't know, but you know, it is what it is. But anyways, let's just go inside. Maybe Brie will cheer me up.
You by yourself this morning?
Yeah.
I know.
Are you still drinking a bunch of water?
Yes. I'm hoping that with this next week, since I'm on vacation, I can actually like move around a bit more.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have to. I'm so burnt out right now. I'm so burnt out. I think we did this next week, right?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna feel burnt out.
Yeah, sometimes that's what you mean.
Because I think I've slept like maybe 3 hours now. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, no, I need to go back to sleep.
Because are you working that late or what? Or you just can't like fall asleep?
That, and I can't fall asleep, but all of a sudden I'll get like a burst of energy after I get off. Good morning, everybody. So obviously this is a 2-for-1 video. Last week it ended abruptly after I got out of the appointment. Honestly, I was just super upset with myself, and yeah, I just wasn't feeling it. I didn't want to post, I didn't want to recap, so I will be doing that today after I go to my appointment today. I have an appointment in about an hour, so I'm about to get ready, but we will go ahead and do a weigh-in right now and see where we're at. Last week, obviously, I had no movement whatsoever, which is, again, another frustrating fucking thing. So, hopefully there's been some movement this week. Cross your fingers. Okay. Awesome. Okay, let's try it again. So, that's number one. Three times a charm. So we're looking at a 97.2, officially under the 300s. So thank God for that.
Okay, babies, I got a couple minutes before I go in. I want to show you these two things really, really fast that like I have been obsessed with lately. It has been the Premier Protein. I get it in the flavor of bananas and cream. This stuff is so good. I even put it in the freezer for a little bit, so it kind of gets like slushies type. It's so, so good. It is 30 grams of protein, 160 calories, 1 gram of sugar, and it has 24 vitamins and minerals. When I wake up, this is the first thing I drink now. That way I can at least kickstart my day with protein. This is the one. She is it. I haven't tried the other flavors yet. Red is always telling me to try different flavors, but this is the one. And then also to offset that, so I can get all my protein first thing in the morning, I have been trying different like protein bars. There was one I got at the gas station the other day that had 65 milligrams of caffeine. I'm trying to find it again in the stores, but the one that I like so far is the Quest protein bar. It is 20 grams of protein, 4 grams of net carbs, and 1 gram of sugar. It is a white chocolate raspberry. She is thick. Like, she is thick. And she is 190 calories. But I'm trying to tell you that this and this is like very filling, and that gives me automatically 50 grams of protein first thing in the morning. So I'm gonna have this as soon as I do my appointments. We are gonna run a few errands today, but I thought I would just show y'all how I'm looking today, rough per usual. Let's go and go inside.
Okay.
thing and not pay attention. What's the pink one?
That one's the Lipo B.
Oh.
So that one has all the B12 and stuff for your metabolism. That's that one you do in your arm.
Okay. Like when I continue, because obviously I have like a month left. Mm-hmm. Do I have to start all over again at the lowest dosage?
Mm-mm.
Oh.
You can just keep going up.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. There's more?
Mm-hmm. Girl, you're still on the second lowest.
No, I know that. But I mean, like, let's say after the third month, I'm like, you know what? Let's just keep going.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you're upping every four weeks.
What's the most you can take?
We have enough.
Because I'm at a seven. I'll be at seven by the end of the whole.
Because you can go up to 15, but I think you can even go more. But this is just like the...
So if I did another 3 months, that would be the dosages. 10, 12, and then 15. Because mm-hmm. that's where I'm going to end up at.
Yeah, so this would be your next dose. So once we do the remaining four, I'd have to see how many times you've done the five. And then if you feel like you want to move up, then we can.
We can
or
continue
if you feel
the
like you're still losing at this one, then we can stay at the five.
Okay. Yeah, I was just curious. I was like, do I have to start over? If I Okay. Mm-hmm.
No.
That's promising, because I was like, man, if I have to start over again, I don't know if my body is going to be like...
Oh, no. Yeah, no. The only time we would lower you is like where if you get to the weight that you want and you kind of just want to maintain. Like, if you're like, I'm good, like, I don't feel like there's more that I want to lose, then we'll just put you at a lower one to maintain you so we're not cutting you off cold turkey.
Okay, yeah.
Because then once we do cold turkey, that's when things kind of go back to how they were. And people start to
miserable.
Like, gain everything back. Mm-hmm.
No shit. Excited.
So according to their paper BMI scale and what I lost last week, I lost a total of 5 pounds. Five. Me, I know I lost like 2.5. I don't know. It just, I'll go in 1 week, weigh whatever I weigh there, and it's like a 5 pound difference. Meanwhile, at home, it was only like 3 pound difference. So I don't know. But you know what? A win is a win. And she's just like, yay. So officially on my paperwork, it's going to say 299.2 or 299.6 on my reading. So I've officially broken their threshold. Meanwhile, I have broken my threshold. I know I don't seem excited or emotional about it, but on the inside, I'm like freaking out. I don't remember ever being 297 pounds. So first goal accomplished, guys. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. And then obviously you heard me ask the questions of if I continue the Mounjaro, like do I have to start over? Do I have to go back to a low dosage? And I can still keep going. Like I can still go higher and higher and higher. So I can only imagine what those higher dosages are going to be like. So definitely going to invest probably in another 3 months, even though I'm literally halfway through. I am definitely ecstatic inside emotionally. I'm just like, holy shit. So now my new goal, if I'm at 297 right now and I still have 6 more shots to go, I would like to essentially lose another... Let's just take it one thing. The next goal would be to be 280. 280 will get me another 17 pounds down, which is crazy. As of right now, I am halfway through my treatment. I'm officially on the 7th shot out of 12. So 6 shots out of 12 are officially have been absorbed into my body, and I am down 27.2 or 27.6 pounds since I started on March 14th. I've never lost that amount of weight except one time, and I did it all wrong. when I broke up with Jesse, for those of you that were with me since 1991, my relationship was 7 years. I literally worked out 3 times a day. I never ate. I did nothing but just kill myself. And I lost like 40 pounds in like a month and a half. And then I gained it all back. We're not doing it that way. We're going to do it the right way. And I'm eating right. So, all right. I hope you guys are enjoying this journey with me. I do apologize for not uploading last week. I was just feeling so just defeated and blasé. But I'm going to continue to post, and we are going to continue to show whether it's, I've had the discussion with myself that whether it is a positive or negative thing that happens in this channel, I will post it no matter what. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and be about my day and start my errands and go tan and pick up some food and things I need so that I can meal prep. There's a lady right next to me. But I hope you guys are enjoying the journey with me. Please leave me a comment down below. I know some of y'all said that you were going to start it. And I'm so happy for this little victory. Like, I'm so excited. I'm so glad that I got my lips done. That was my little thing for myself. So I just got to figure out what the next goal is going to be as far as what I'm going to do for myself. This lady's going to hit my car. I can feel it. But I love y'all so much. And I hope you guys are enjoying this. And until next time, bye. Bye.